When I was running my award-winning restaurant, Audrey's, we employed the most wonderful assistant chef called Simone. Now, she worked with us for almost 5 years, and the day she left to get married, we were all understandably quite devastated. I mean, sadly, the marriage didn't last. He was an accountant, a little too familiar with several clients, which would be terribly heartbreaking for poor Simone. We're still yet to re-partner, as they call it these days. Anyway, this dish is one of Simone's absolute favourites, and I'm sure she won't mind me sharing it with you today. Pasta with prosciutto. Now, the ingredients are all perfectly straightforward. Tomatoes, vine-ripened, of course, mushrooms, prosciutto, garlic and onion, and my favourite, cream. Now, the pasta I'm using is rigatoni. You could use fusilli or penne, and you could even use tagliatelle if you don't mind ruining it. Let's start with the tomatoes. Now, I picked these up from the local farmer's market. I mean, look at them. Soft, plump, vibrant, juicy. I mean, frankly, how anyone can even look at a supermarket tomato baffles me. Then again, some people use pre-grated Parmesan cheese. There's no accounting for taste there. All right, let's get started. Tomatoes are best peeled before using them, and the easiest way to do this is to mark a small cross in the base of them, and then place them into a pot of boiling water. A few minutes is all it should take, and the peel should come off quite easily. Time to finely slice your onion. Put a little olive oil in the pan, nice and hot, and then add your onion and give it a stir. People often wonder how to tell when your onion is cooked, and it's quite simple. The onion needs to be translucent. Right, if you have to imagine a sunroom with windows built of onion instead of glass, there should be enough light coming through your onion glass for you to comfortably read a copy of Country Life magazine without having to turn the lamp on. While that's cooking, I want you to slice a few cloves of garlic. Now take your freshly peeled tomatoes and chop them coarsely. Add your tomatoes and garlic to the pan and give it a stir. A pinch of salt and pepper, freshly ground of course. Let the tomatoes cook covered for a few minutes until softened. At this stage, it's time to add our pasta to the boiling water. Now it's time for our piece de resistance, the prosciutto. It's an Italian cured pork, similar to pancetta, but I prefer it because it's leaner and just that little bit harder to pronounce. It also has a wonderfully subtle taste. Right, chop your prosciutto roughly and add it to your pan, followed by some freshly picked rosemary needles. Add a glug of cream, or a splodge for those who prefer imperial measurements. Isn't it funny how wary of dairy products have all become in recent times? I mean, people have absolute conniptions at the merest mention of butter. Actually, I might just pop a bit in there too. Add a spoonful of chilies to your dish and bring your tomato prosciutto sauce to the boil. By this stage, your pasta should be ready. So just test a bit. Perfect. Now toss the sauce through and grate some fresh Parmesan. Serve with a crispy loaf of bread and a jauntily tossed salad. Pasta perfection. Until we eat again. Enjoy.